friends, I hope I'm audible and visible. Please give me a quick thumbs up if my audio video is all fine. And without wasting much time, we'll start with today's session. So before starting, let me introduce myself. I'm Dr. Cheshta Agarwal, your NEET PG educator on an academy. And I've myself scored All India rank 261 in my entrance examination. Now you all are on the best online platform for the preparation of NEET PG, and that is Unacademy. Unacademy is the best online platform for the preparation. How to download this? You can search for Unacademy Learning app in the App Store. After downloading it, you have to choose your category, which is NEET PG. Once you choose a category, you'll see a lot of things available on the Unacademy platform. For example, there are a lot of stuff available for free and a lot of stuff available as paid. The free stuffs are, you have a lot of questions and you have free live special classes. You have free live special classes and you have a vast question bank. Now, by using a code that is Dr. Cheshta YT, by using a code called as Dr. Cheshta YT, you can access all these free stuff. So this is a sort of a welcome code for all of you. So please go ahead, download the Unacademy app and at least get access to the free classes. Now, suppose if you like the free classes and you want to go for a paid subscription, we have two type. One is Plus, another is Iconic. Now, what is Plus? Plus give you an access to live classes on the Unacademy, the structured courses, the weekly test and unlimited access to the platform. And today's topic is, it's a mixed bag question. This is a 60 minute session. I will be telling you one question per minute. So it will be like a marathon MCQ session for quick revision of dermatology. Theek hai ji? Okay. So we have Iconic subscription, which provides Plus was providing the access to Unacademy, while Iconic is providing the access to both Unacademy and PrepLadder. It provides access to both Unacademy and PrepLadder. PrepLadder has an added advantage of video lectures and rapid revision courses. Now, we have recently introduced a 4-year subscription. And if you get a 4-year subscription, look at this. The per month cost is reduced to a lot. That is 1,200 rupees per month. Using my referral code, Dr. Cheshta YT will give you additional 10% discount. So try to use this as the referral code. And please remember, we have no cost EMI options also available. So you can have payments every month with no extra money. For Iconic, we have options of 1 year, 2 year, 3 years and so on. And again, if you use the code Dr. Cheshta YT, you'll get additional 10% discount on it. Now, we still continues with a 3+1 offer, that if you buy a 3-month subscription, 1 month is free. And if you buy a 12-month subscription, the 2 month is absolutely free. So you can go with this 3+1 or 12+2 offers. And as I've told you always, that the Iconic subscription prices has been revised. You can compare it yourself. Previously, they were too high, but now we have reduced this almost to the half. So please go and subscribe. Using the code Dr. Cheshta YT will give you additional discount on the reduced prices. Now, 4-year subscription is available for both the Iconic as well as Plus. You can avail this again using the code Dr. Cheshta YT. We have introduced a feature which is raise a hand on the Plus subscription, that here you can interact with your co-educators or with your co-learners and educators simultaneously. So it will help you in one-to-one interaction with doubt solving feature. New batch courses like Focus FMG batch course started on 23rd, which will prepare you for FMG December 2021. We have NEET PG session batch course again started on 23rd. Then MBBS professional batch course, I think everybody is enjoying the dermatology classes here. We have a lot of students live in this session and everybody is enjoying dermatology in detail, I guess. And we have 3rd year batch courses where PSM, Ophthalmology, ENT and a 1st year batch course where anatomy, physiology and biochemistry are taught to you in detail. So I hope everybody is enjoying this. And we have another batch course for the next pattern examination started on the 23rd. So please try to focus on all these courses and use my code to get additional discount. And the code is Dr. Cheshta YT. You can even use the code CHESHTA10 to get 10% discount on whatever subscription you take. So I will be giving you very, very less time per question. It would be around 15 to 30 seconds per question. Quickly answer this question. We have 60 questions with us. I want to discuss every question with you. So without wasting, I want all of you to answer this question. Few questions are previous year MCQs. So you will have a revision of PYQs along with this class. So quickly answer all my dear students, Mishba, yours, Jayalakshmi, please answer this question, all of you. The patient was treated with steroid for psoriasis. On stopping the treatment, he develops fever, malaise, lesions as seen in the image below. What is the most probable diagnosis? Very nice, Jayalakshmi. You are absolutely right. In a patient of psoriasis, if you start steroids, there could be two possibilities. One is erythrodermic, another is pustular. Erythrodermic will have generalized erythema and pustular will have localized or generalized pustular eruptions in them. So please remember, this is very, very important. The two types of psoriasis which occurs when you start a patient on steroids. Understood, all of you? So please give me a quick thumbs up. Please give me a quick thumbs up. I hope that is clear to all of you. So the answer here is acute generalized pustular psoriasis. And can anybody quickly tell me what is the treatment of choice? Mishba, Jayalakshmi, anybody can tell me what is our treatment of choice in this particular patient? Anybody can tell me? Remember that treatment of choice here becomes retinoids, and that too oral retinoids, which is acitretin. Theek hai ji, done. It is oral retinoid, that is acitretin. Another question, please answer all of the following infections presents with maculopapular rash except. It could be a repeat question. Quickly, without wasting time, I want all my students to answer. Where do you not develop a macule or a papule rash? Dengue, rubella, shigella, measles, Jayalakshmi, Mishba, yours, waiting for all the students' answer. We have 13 students right now with us. So please quickly answer all my dear and dear students. Very nice, Jayalakshmi, very nice. And okay, so Parshal, please remember that in dengue, rubella and measles, you will see presence of macule, or you will see presence of papule, or you can see the combination of macule and papule. But remember in shingles, you will have presence of vesiculobullous eruptions. You will have grouped vesicles which can convert to form large bulla or can convert into pustule. So very nice, Varsha and Damari, I want you to just remember, shingles is nothing but another name for herpes zoster. And how to treat this? Anyone, how to treat this? Remember that for treating herpes zoster, you have to give antivirals, which could be acyclovir or which could be valacyclovir. Acyclovir should be given in a dose of 800 mg 5 times a day, and valacyclovir 1 gram TDS. So that should be your treatment protocol for treating herpes zoster. Coming to the next question, a patient with flaccid bullous lesion involves the oral cavity and the skin. He has lesions as shown in the picture below. I hope this image is visible. If not, I can just move it little left, so that you all can have a look on the image. Theek hai ji, quickly look at this image. The acantholytic cells on Zhang smear, what is the most probable diagnosis? What is the most probable diagnosis? That is pemphigus vulgaris, bullous pemphigoid, pemphigus foliaceus and dermatitis herpetiformis. Theek hai ji, so please try to answer this. Very, very important for your exams. Mishba, Jayalakshmi, Rajat, very well done all of you. The patient with flaccid bullous lesions involving the oral cavity and the skin, and he has the lesion as shown in the picture below. Acantholytic cells are seen on the Zhang smear. What is the probable diagnosis? Pemphigus vulgaris, bullous pemphigoid, pemphigus foliaceus or dermatitis herpetiformis. Very nice. It is pemphigus vulgaris. Always remember, if you see intraepidermal split, it could be because of three things. They can give you three hints in the question. When you have to think about intraepidermal hit, when either of these three is present in the question, that is flaccid bulla or acantholytic cell, or they say Nikolsky sign is positive. If any of these words is given in the question, always think about intraepidermal acantholytic disorder. And along with acantholytic disorder, if they give you presence of oral lesions, nothing other than pemphigus vulgaris. If they tell you that oral cavity is involved, nothing other than pemphigus should be your option. Did you understand? Okay, done. So this is a very easy question. Let's move to the next question. Which of the following is true association? Abhishek, Shikhar, Rajat, Sabyasachi, Mishba, Jayalakshmi, Rajat, Damari, Varsha. Everybody is welcome in this class. Please be a little bit quicker. It's a rapid fire session or a marathon session where I will be discussing one question every minute. So I want your answers as fast as possible so that we can cover maximum question in the today's session. Which of the following is true association? Lichen planus malignant melanoma, psoriasis metabolic syndrome, melasma malignant melanoma, vitiligo or metabolic syndrome. Very nice, everybody. I can see your answers here. Very nice, Sabyasachi, Mishba, Abhishek, Jayalakshmi. Anybody else? We have 20 students with us. Very well done. Anybody else? What about you, Rajat? What about you, Shikhar? Very nice. The correct answer here is option number 2. You are absolutely right, Priya. Remember that psoriasis is associated with metabolic syndrome. What do you mean by metabolic syndrome? There are a lot of associations. For example, presence of obesity. For example, presence of hypercholesterolemias. What else? Obesity also they will give you in question increased waist to hip ratio. They can use this term also, increase waist to hip ratio. Obesity, hypercholesterolemia, even diabetes mellitus, PCOS, all these are more frequently associated with psoriasis. And remember that the psoriatic individual are more prone for cardiovascular accidents. Remember that they are more prone for cardiovascular accident. So you always need to monitor the metabolic syndromes associated with them. Understood? So please remember, Shreya, it is not option number 3. It is option number 2, which is the correct answer. Psoriasis and metabolic syndrome. Treatment of multibacillary. I want 100% of you to answer this question because I think this is a sort of candy question or a lollipop question. Everybody will answer this question correct. I'm sure for that. So try to answer this. Varsha, Shreya, Damari, Priya. Then we have Mishba, Jayalakshmi, Sabyasachi, Abhishek, Shikhar, Rajat. Who else we have with us in this session? Yours. Anybody with the answers? Treatment of multibacillary. Please remember, WHO now follows what is called as uniform MDT. WHO now follows something called as uniform MDT. TKG. What do you mean by this uniform MDT? Uniform MDT means whether it is posibacillary or multibacillary, the strict protocol is you have to give 3 drugs. You don't have any 2 drug protocol. WHO have made this clear, or the National Leprosy Eradication Program have made this clear, that there is no 2 drug therapy from now onwards. You have 3 drug, but the only difference is in the duration. The duration of the 3 drug in PB is 6 month, and for MB or multibacillary it is 12 month. So the correct answer becomes 3 drugs in 12 months. I hope that is clear. TKG, very nice. Shikhar, Varsha, Sabyasachi, Damari. Then you have Yamuna with us. Very nice, all my dear students. Chalo ji, fatafat check. Quickly answer the next question given on the computer screen. Female came with a foul smelling grey white discharge, and on examination one of these will be seen on microscopy. Okay, so Abhishek, so marathon is with respect to the number of questions. So definitely in marathon you have to run slowly, but this term is used with respect to so many questions. In marathon you have to travel long, right? So you have to travel or cover a long distance. So here we are covering more questions, and that is why we are calling it as a marathon session. Understood, Abhishek? Yes or no? Chalo ji. So female with a foul smelling grayish white discharge, on examination one of these will be seen on microscopy. So please remember, foul smelling discharge, white discharge. Is it clicking something in your mind? Yes, this becomes a case of bacterial vaginosis. It becomes a case of bacterial vaginosis. And in bacterial vaginosis, what do you see? In bacterial vaginosis, we see that the vaginal epithelial cells, they are studded with the organisms, they are studded with the bacteria on their margins like this. The bacteria is not inside the cell, but bacteria is onto the cell, and this is called as a clue cell. Clear hai ki nahi? Please give me a thumbs up. This is a clue cell. And Mishba and Shreya, can you tell me, for putting it under the EMCLS criteria, how many clue cells should be present? Anyone, for putting it under the EMCLS criteria, what percentage? Very nice. It should be 20% of the total vaginal epithelial cells should be the clue cells, and then we will consider it as one of the criteria of EMCLS. Chalo ji, the next question. Clear? So Abhishek, what about you? You have not answered this question. So please answer this question. A child present with a bald patch on the scalp with easy pluckability of hair. Physician noted black dot on the area. The treatment to be given will be amphotericin B, fluconazole, griseofulvin, cyclopyroxolamine. Anyone can tell me the answer. A child with bald patch on the scalp with easy pluckability of hair. What about diagnosis? Anyone? Anyone, what this could be? Very nice. This is a classical case of tinea capitis. What type of tinea capitis? Non-inflammatory. Again, what type of non-inflammatory? It is the black dot tinea. Very nice. It's a black dot tinea. And I hope you remember the mnemonic black and white TV. So that is tonsurance and the presence of violation. TKG, very, very important. Yes, and it is also called as the ectothrix variety. The correct answer is griseofulvin. We will prefer griseofulvin over fluconazole if it is the scalp fungus. Otherwise, fluconazole becomes a better option. Okay? Now, there is a lot of confusion that, ma'am, what should be the treatment of choice whenever they ask you a question of tinea? So remember that for scalp tinea, we usually prefer to give griseofulvin. But for other places like tinea cruris, corporis, terbinafim becomes a very, very important choice, or you can even consider it to be a treatment of choice for the other sorts of tinea. Griseofulvin nowadays not given for other areas because there is a lot of resistance being developed, against this griseofulvin. Theek hai ji? Chalo. An alcoholic patient presented with the lesion as shown in the image, associated with diarrhea. Which deficiency it is associated with? So let's show you the image. An alcoholic patient with lesions, he also has diarrhea. What becomes the correct answer? Shreya, Mishba, Varsha, Sabyasachi, Yamuna, Rajat, Priya, Shikhar, then we have with us Jayalakshmi, then who else? Damari, please answer this question quickly. Terbinafin, there's no 200 dose of terbinafin. Terbinafin comes in 250 mg dose. Theek hai ji? And not TDS. Arey baap re, who told you that? OD is sufficient. 250 mg OD is sufficient. Theek hai ji? You don't have to give it TDS. No. If at all the body weight is too high, you can give 500 mg terbinafin. But we usually prefer to give a low dose and continue it for a longer duration. Theek hai ji? So this is a classical case of pellagra, which is a niacin deficiency or vitamin B3 deficiency. And please remember, the precursor of niacin is tryptophan, and that is why for this question it becomes tryptophan as the correct answer. Hana ji, samajh gaye? Very nice. Now comes the next question. The ulcer with the overhanging undermined edges in the neck region as shown in the image given below. What is your diagnosis? Please answer this question. Tuberculoid lymph nodes, malignant cervical lymphadenopathy, syphilis, reactive lymphadenopathy. Anyone? As I've told you, this session also includes a lot of PYQs. So I request all of you to please go through this session, because PYQs you should know at least, you know, because it will give you an idea that which important topics, which are the important topics that could can be asked in the further classes or exams. So Ayush, Damari, Shreya, Sadhishachi, Rajat, Shikhar, Jayalakshmi, Mishba, everybody is right. When you see an ulcer with undermined edges, overhanging lesion, it becomes a classical case of tubercular lymph node, also known as scrofuloderma. Very nice, Mishma. Scrofuloderma becomes the option here. Theek hai ji. Samaj gaye, done ki nahi, done, done, done. Chalo ji. Let's do the next question. Which mineral deficiency can lead to this condition? Look at the classical site. Look at the classical appearance. Periorificial, burnt out lesion. Will you see these lesions in zinc, iron, calcium or vitamin A? That is the question. So where will you see this type of periorificial burnt out lesions? In which among the four options provided? Very nice, Jayalakshmi. Absolutely right. Anybody else want to answer? Shreya, Mishba, Ayush, Lydia, Priya, everybody, Sabhisachi, Yamuna, you're right. This is a case of zinc deficiency, and the congenital zinc deficiency is also known as acrodermatitis. Acrodermatitis enteropathica. Acrodermatitis enteropathica is the term used for this. Okay, very, very important. Which mineral deficiency can lead to the following condition? Acrodermatitis enteropathica, which is the congenital deficiency of zinc. Okay, ji? So here you can see that these patients have associated dermatitis, diarrhea, and alopecia. And to remember this, we have a mnemonic, and that is DAD. Okay, so we have dermatitis, which is periorificial. Then we have diarrhea, and we have alopecia or loss of hair. This is how the patients of zinc deficiency presents to you. Okay, ji. Please look at the question. The first line treatment of acne comedones. If anybody is attending my plus sessions, I have told or I have taught this everything in detail for the treatment of acne. Anybody is live in my plus courses. First line treatment for acne comedones: topical steroids, topical antibiotic, benzoyl peroxide or topical retinoids. Okay, ji? First line treatment for acne comedones. First line treatment for acne comedones. Very nice, Priya, Shikhar, Shreya, Mishba. Very well done. First line treatment for acne comedone. The correct answer here is topical retinoids. See what happens. Why acne comedones develop? Because in the patients, you have follicular, you have obstruction at the follicular opening here. There is hyperkeratinization, and because of this, there is obstruction to the outflow of sebaceous material. So this is the sebaceous gland. The sebaceous gland is forming sebaceous material like this, but because of the obstruction, this material is not coming out. It is getting accumulated, and that is why there is comedone. So you need something which can remove this plug of hypercornification, and that is done by the topical retinoids, which is a keratolytic agent. Understood, G? Yes, this is a grade 1 acne where topical retinoids becomes the treatment of choice. Chalo, G. Please answer the next question. If you want, I can just move it little on the left so that it becomes better visualized. Identify the condition shown in the image. Anybody can tell me the condition here? Very nice, Raj, Ravi, Mishba, Shreya, Varsha, Rajat. The correct answer of this question is malignant melanoma. Now, I've seen question students getting confused always between BCC and malignant melanoma. Please remember, BCC will have nodulo ulcerative form. Now, if you look at this image, can you see any nodule or ulcer? No. So please remember, only looking at the color of the lesion, and if it is black, you are making it as basal cell carcinoma. That is not true. Please try to look at the morphology of the lesion, and it clearly shows that you have a macule with variable pigmentation. At few places it is light, at few places it is dark. And you always have the irregularity in the shape, size, color, this becomes a case of malignant melanoma. Remember that A, B, C, D, E criteria. So please don't get confused. Basal cell carcinoma, the commonest variety is nodulo ulcerative. ठीक है जी, अंडरस्टूड मिशबा, लिडिया, श्रेया, दीपक, राज, रवि, वर्षा, ऑल ऑफ यू. एंड यस, दिस इज द एक्रल लेंटिजिनस टाइप. एब्सोल्युटली राइट रजत, दिस इज एन एक्रल लेंटिजिनस टाइप ऑफ मेलेनोमा. विच ऑर्गेनिज्म इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग इरिसिपिलस? एनीवन? विच ऑर्गेनिज्म इज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर कॉजिंग इरिसिपिलस? स्ट्रेप्टोकोकस, स्टेफाइलोकोकस, बैक्टीरॉइडस और फंगस? Streptococcus, Staphylococcus, Bacteroides or Fungus. Very nice, Nikita, Raj, Ravi, Sabyasachi. Which organism is responsible for causing erysipelas? The correct answer is Streptococcus. ठीक है जी, एंड वॉट दिस इमेज शोज, इट शोज अ करेक्टरिस्टिक मिलियन ईयर साइन. यू हैव इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द ईयर पिन्ना इन द पेशेंट्स ऑफ इरिसिपिलस, बट दैट इज नॉट ट्रू विद द पेशेंट्स ऑफ सेलुलाइटिस. वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ठीक है जी, ओके. क्यूटेनियस हॉर्न एज शोन इन द इमेज इज एसोसिएटेड विद विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग स्किन कंडीशन? एनी वन विद द आंसर? Anybody with the answer? Anyone can tell me the answer of this question? I hope you all can. Very nice. The cutaneous horn as shown in the image is associated with which of the following skin cancer? Remember that correct answer is squamous cell carcinoma. The cutaneous horn is associated with, or it is a pre-malignant condition which, if not taken care of at appropriate time, it can convert into malignancy, and that is squamous cell carcinoma. ठीक है जी. Another question. Identify the image shown. You have to tell me what is that. Condyloma acuminata, Bowen's disease, condyloma lata or hemorrhoidus. Anyone? Anybody can tell me the answer here? Mishba, Lydia, anyone? Rajat? I hope that is clear to all of you. Very nice. You all are right. Identify the condition shown in the image. This is a classical image of condyloma acuminata. What is condyloma acuminata? It is genital wart. What is condyloma acuminata? It is genital wart, which is a human papilloma viral infection. And what species? 6 and 11. Remember, human papilloma virus type 6 and 11 are the species which causes it. ठीक है जी, but condyloma lata, which is a very very similar terminology, it is nothing but secondary syphilis. Clear all of you? Please give me a quick thumbs up if this question is clear. Everybody give me a quick thumbs up. चलो जी, the next question is here on your computer screen. Can anybody answer this question? Anyone? Very nice, very nice, all of you, very nice. Now please remember, whenever you see, if this is not visible, I can move it little on the left. I'm very sorry if this is not visible, we can move it little on the left. So patient suffering from ulcerative colitis presents with ulcer on the anterior leg as shown in the image, what could be your diagnosis? Very nice. Background of inflammatory bowel disorder, in a patient with a rapidly progressing ulcer over the leg, which is not responding to antibiotics, remember that it becomes a case of pyoderma gangrenosum. And what do you have to give in these patients? Give oral steroids along with Dapsone, which will take care of it. Very nice. It's a classical case of neutrophilic dermatosis. This is not sweet syndrome. This is pyoderma gangrenosum. Theek hai ji? Okay. Let's do the next question given on your computer screen. Please do the next question, all of you. Please do the next question. I think there was some issue with the connection. Am I audible, visible right now? Am I audible, visible? Yes. So the common complication, I hope I am audible and visible now. Please give me a quick thumbs up. The common complication associated with the following condition, please remember, it is a non-bullous impetigo. And a non-bullous impetigo, which is secondary to what? Streptococcus. Which species? Group A, beta hemolytic streptococcus. Group A, beta hemolytic streptococcus. And can you tell me what strain I am talking about here? The strain is M49. So please remember, this will cause post-streptococcal glomerulonephritis. Okay? So the commonest complication secondary to non-bullous impetigo with this strain M49 group A beta hemolytic streptococcus becomes option number one. Another question. So I'll move the image little on the left so that it becomes clear. This was a repeat question. So I hope you all will solve this. Mishba, Ruhi, Deepak, Damari, Jayalakshmi, Varsha, Raj Ravi, Shikhar, Shreya, all of you, I hope now the audio video becomes clear, everything is fine. Hanji, Chal, please answer this question, everyone. A tourist guide in the Mount Everest, after one of his trips, developed blisters on the foot, which is not used for its treatment. Very nice, again a very easy question. So what happens when you go to Mount Everest? What happens? The temperature is too low, too cold. So whenever you have colder environments, your body have or your blood gets vasoconstricted. Whenever you have cooler environments, there is vasoconstriction of the blood vessels. And whenever you have vasoconstriction of the blood vessels, the supply, the blood supply to the end arteries or the organ supply by the end arteries get compromised. Same thing happens when you go to a cooler environment, there is vasoconstriction and the blood supply to the distal extremity get compromised, giving rise to something called as frostbite. So you need to give a treatment modality which causes either vasodilatation or which supplies more oxygen or the drug which prevents the obstruction to the flow. So you can give hyperbaric oxygen, you can give aspirin, you can give pentoxifilin, but remember that there is no role of phenylephrine in taking care of the frost bites. Theek hai ji? Please remember, there is no role of phenylephrine. Rest, all three can be given. And this was a question from FMG, past question. Okay, the next question. The patient presented with a history of severe sunburn after only a few minutes in the sun, freckling in sun-exposed areas, dry skin, changes in the skin pigmentation. What could be the diagnosis? Patient presented with a history of severe sunburn after only a few minutes in the sun, freckling in the sun-exposed areas, dry skin, changes in the skin pigmentation. What is the diagnosis? Very nice, Jayalakshmi, Shikhar, Raj Ravi, Harshita. This becomes a very, very classical image where you have freckling. You can see that there is presence of skin, chronic skin lesions in the form of cutaneous malignancies. So this becomes a patient of xeroderma pigmentosa. Again, a repeat question from FMG. So remember that xeroderma pigmentosa is a nucleotide excision repair defect. It's a nucleotide excision repair defects which presents with the damage to the sun exposed skin. And why there is damage? Because the UV radiation causes some alteration in the nucleus, and this nucleus alterations are not repaired because of defect in nucleotide excision repair, giving rise to multiple malignancies, very, very classically seen in xeroderma pigmentosa. Next question. Child with soreness in mouth and rash on the hand, feet, what is the causative agent for this? Anyone? The child with soreness in mouth, rash on the hand, feet, what is the causative organism for this? Raj, Ravi, Deepak, Mishba, waiting for your answers, all of you. Good. So this is a patient with ulcers over mouth, rashes over hand and feet. It becomes a case of hand, foot and mouth disease. Hand, foot and mouth disease. And yes, you all are right. It is seen secondary to an enterovirus, which is Coxsackie A16. Please remember, it is A16, not B, not C, not D. Because I've seen a lot of questions being asked. Okay, can you answer this question? I can move it a little on the left. Child presents with fever, pleomorphic rash. What could be your diagnosis? What is the patient's presentation in the picture of tongue of xeroderma? Is it related to XP? Yes, it could be related, but we are not sure because there was no history given to that. In the tongue, it could be because of, you know, the damage which occurs. It could be because of bite. But as such, in xeroderma pigmentosa, particularly something on tongue is not that frequently seen. Okay? Understood, Nikita? Okay. So, a child present with fever, pleomorphic rash as shown in the image, what becomes your diagnosis? A child with fever and rash, what could be your diagnosis? The correct answer becomes chickenpox. The correct answer becomes chickenpox, which is very, very important. DKG. And what is this appearance called as? This appearance is called as dewdrop on rose petal. Look clearly. They are transparent vesicle, and if you look that there is surrounding erythema. So as if there is a rose petal, and on those petals there are fine drops of transparent fluid in them. So this is how a patient of, what do you say, chickenpox appears. Chickenpox also known as varicella. The time of reading the patch for allergic contact dermatitis according to International Contact Dermatitis Research Group, ICDRG is, anyone? Can you answer this question? Why not three? Why not three? Measles. Please remember, this dewdrop over the rose petal, that is classical of chickenpox. In measles, you will see macule papule first. Then, in a very rare condition, you will see vesicles. So, measles will have more common presentation of macule and papule. Vesicles are not that frequent. Who have asked me? Aditi, understood? I hope this question is clear. Okay, G. Now for this question, the correct answer is, anyone? Very nice. It is 48 and so 2 day and 4 day. That becomes the correct answer. 2 days means 48 hours and 4 day means 92 to 96 hours. Okay, G. So in patch test, you put a patch on day 1. And you will ask the patient to come again after 48 hours, that is on day 2. You will remove the patch, you will send the patient again home, and you will ask them to come again after 2 days, that is 96 hours from day 1. And when the patient comes on the day 4, you will read it. You can read it as plus, plus, plus. Plus means you have only erythema. Double plus means there is presence of papules along with erythema, and triple plus means you have a hypersensitive response in the form of pustules or there is erosions or something like that. Okay? So best is 48 and 96. Very nice, Aditi. Chalo ji, let's answer the next question. The patient with fever, severe joint pain comes to you. She also developed pigmentation of nose subsequently. What is your answer? Anyone? A patient with fever, joint pain comes to you. She also developed pigmentation of nose. What becomes the likely diagnosis? Very nice. Please remember, the fever and joint pain in this particular patient is because of chikungunya fever. Chikungunya fever. And chikungunya fever is very, very frequently associated with centrofacial pigmentation. The pigmentation over the nose, over the upper lip, very, very frequently seen. The centrofacial type of pigmentation. ठीक है जी, दिस इज कॉल्ड एज चिक साइन. ठीक है, चिक साइन. सो चिक फॉर चिकन गुनिया. ठीक है जी, दिस चिक इज फॉर चिकन गुनिया. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग विल शो कैंकर रिडक्स. कैंकर रिडक्स मीन्स रीअपियरेंस ऑफ प्राइमरी कैंकर. वेयर डू यू सी रीअपियरेंस ऑफ प्राइमरी कैंकर और वेयर डू यू सी कैंकर रिडक्स, दैट इज द क्वेश्चन. प्रिया, डॉक्टर शोभा, अनुजा, निकिता, अदिति, रजत. वेरी नाइस ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स. विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग विल शो कैंकर रिडक्स, अर्ली रिलैप्सिंग सिफिलिस, शैंक्रोइड, लेट सिफिलिस और हर्पीज. कैन यू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन फॉर मी, रीअपियरेंस ऑफ प्राइमरी कैंकर. Very nice. So remember that. Remember everyone. Reappearance of primary canker is seen in a patient of latent syphilis who develop relapse. Now usually what happens, you have three stages. Primary, where you have canker. Then you have secondary, where you have hematogenous spread and involvement of the body. Then you have a latent period where there is no cutaneous feature, only lab abnormalities. And later is a tertiary phase where you have complications in the form of cardiovascular or CNS involvement. But sometimes what happens, the patient from latent syphilis, instead of going towards the tertiary syphilis, it goes back to primary syphilitic stage where they have reappearance of primary canker, and these stages is called as early relapsing syphilis, and this reappearance of the primary canker is called as canker redux. Understood, Mishba, Prasad, Sikhar, Aditi, Shreya? I hope you remember this. Now comes another question. 22-year-old college students with history of intercourse with multiple sex workers came with centrally umbilicated lesions on his genital area. Scraping from the lesions will show. Anyone? College students with a history of intercourse with multiple sex workers came with centrally umbilicated lesions on his genital area. Scraping from the lesions will show. Yes, very nice, Dr. Shobha. You're right that pseudocanker redux is a feature of. Very nice, very nice. Yeah, tertiary syphilis. Now, here comes a very important question or interesting question. Now, in a young female who is sexually active, she developed umbilicated lesions. Yes, umbilicated means it should click in your mind, molluscum lesions. Theek hai ji, umbilicated bole to molluscum, and for molluscum you have intra cytoplasmic inclusion body. So inclusion bodies are present inside the cell, and what are these called as? These are called as Henderson Peterson bodies. These are called as Henderson Peterson bodies. I hope this is clear to all of you. Very important, very interesting. 22-year-old college student with history of intercourse with multiple sex partners, centrally umbilicated lesions on the genital areas, scraping from the lesions will show what? Henderson-Peterson body, which are intracytoplasmic inclusion bodies. Chalo ji. Another question is on your screen. So quickly, I will be moving it here. So please answer all of you. A patient comes with a cauliflower growth on the foot. He's farmer by occupation. Scraping shows following. What could be your diagnosis? Quickly answer. Dr. Shobha, electrocautery will not be... we will not prefer it because you can remove the molluscum simply by curating it. Theek hai ji? So you can even use a simple molluscum curator. You have to remove the central part and that is all done. Theek hai ji? Okay. So patient comes with a cauliflower growth on the foot. He is farmer by occupation. Scraping shows the following diagnosis. Very nice. It is nothing but copper penny. It is nothing but copper penny bodies or sclerotic bodies or medullar bodies. Theek hai ji? कॉपर पेनी बॉडीज, स्क्लेरोटिक बॉडीज और मेडुलर बॉडीज, वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर योर एग्जाम. ओके, अरेंज द फॉलोइंग ब्लिस्टरिंग डिसऑर्डर्स फ्रॉम सुपरफिशियल टू डीप. दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट अलॉट. सो दीज टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चन यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट अलॉट. सो प्लीज ट्राई टू आंसर दिस क्वेश्चन. अरेंज द फॉलोइंग ब्लिस्टरिंग डिसऑर्डर्स फ्रॉम सुपरफिशियल टू डीप. वेरी नाइस वर्षा, डॉक्टर शोभा, प्रवीण, रजत, श्रेया, राज रवि, देन वी हैव दमारी, अदिति, अनुजा, प्रिया, जयलक्ष्मी, हर्षिता, देन वी हैव निकिता, एवरीवन. अरेंज द फॉलोइंग ब्लिस्टरिंग डिसऑर्डर्स फ्रॉम सुपरफिशियल टू डीप. शिखर, यू आर राइट, एवरीबडी इज राइट. नाउ प्लीज रिमेंबर, इन पेम्फिगस वल्गैरिस, in pemphigus vulgaris you have the level of split at supra basal level, that is just above the stratum basal layer. In bullous pemphigoid it is at the level of basement membrane. In foliaceous it is at the level of subcorneum. Theek hai ji. And in dystrophica it is at the level of dermis, deeper, it is at the level of dermis. Is that clear all of you? Please give me a quick thumbs up if you understood. Very very important. Please give me a quick thumbs up if this is clear. Yes, very nice. So it is at a level of dermis. Now how does or what is the structure of skin? You have stratum corneum superficial like this, then below this you have stratum granulosum, then below stratum granulosum you have stratum spinosum, then you have stratum basale like this, theek hai ji, and then you have basement membrane and dermis. So that is how the image looks like when you take a biopsy stratum basale. Now please remember, whenever you have suprabasal split, it is somewhere here. So this comes the subcorneal, which is the superficial one seen in the patients of pemphigus foliaceus. Suprabasal is somewhere here, basement membrane is here, and dermis is here. So the exact sequence in this question, the exact sequence becomes number 3, I'll use a black color pen, number 3, followed by number 1. Followed by number 2, followed by number 4, and that is option number. Yes, Shreya, you are right. In EB dystrophic, the collagen 7 are defective. Okay? You have deficiency of collagen 7 in the patients of EB dystrophic. A child with target lesion on palm and sole, he also has oral mucosal lesion. What could be the likely diagnosis? Anyone can answer this question. What could be the likely diagnosis? A child present with the target lesions on palm and sole, he also has oral mucosal lesion. What could be the likely diagnosis? Very nice, very nice, very nice, everyone. Very nice. So we have Dr. Shobha, Shreya, Rajat, Anuja, Rajeshwari. A child present with the target lesion, whenever they give you target lesion, one thing should come into your mind. No, that is not hand, foot and mouth disease. Again, target lesion. Did I tell you target lesion in hand, foot and mouth disease? No, it is erythema multiforme. So everybody have made the mistake here. Only Harshita is right. Harshita is right and Shreyas is right. Please remember, it is a case of erythema multiforme. Target lesion in palm and sole, oral mucosal lesion, it is a case of herpes simplex infection, which is the most common infective cause for erythema multiforme. Is that clear all of you? Please don't mark the question in hurry. Even a single word is very important. So target lesion will change everything. Oral lesions, palm and sole, target lesion, answer has become the erythema multiforme, that is herpes simplex virus. Done. Everybody was wrong except 2 or 3. So please try to remember it. Very, very important. Theek hai ji? Chalo. Pregnant lady who is having chicken pox comes to you, the adverse reaction of this infection would be maximum to the fetus at very nice Mishba, Priya, Barsha, Shikhar, Raj, Ravi. The pregnant lady who is having chicken pox comes to you, the adverse reaction of this condition would be maximum to the fetus at. So this is actually a question of microbiology. So they want to ask that during which time there is a maximum transfer of the varicella virus from the mother to the fetus. The transplacental transfer they are talking about. Please remember, the risk is maximum at 13 to 20th week, and after that it suddenly decreases. And why it is so? Because it is said that there is a thick trophoblastic layer which forms after 13 to 20th week, and that is why there is no further transfer of the varicella to the fetus. So if it occurs before or at 13 to 20th week, you have a maximum risk of transferring the infection to the fetus. Clear all of you? So it is 13 to 20th week which becomes the correct answer. Understood, Rajeshwari, Anuja, Barsha, all of you? Chalo. The next question is on your computer screen. I want all the students, all of my students, to try answering this. The patient with leprosy diagnosed with Debson, he developed complication of Debson toxicity. Investigations here would be, anyone, what will be your investigation? Arterial blood gas with methemoglobinemia levels, chest x-ray, carboxy hemoglobin levels, or renal function test. What could be your answer? What will be your answer? Anyone? A patient with leprosy diagnosis was started on Debson, however he developed complication of Dexon toxicity. Investigations here would be arterial blood gas with methemoglobin level, chest x-ray, carboxy hemoglobin levels, or renal function test. Please remember, the correct answer here is option number 1. When you give Debson for a longer period, or even if you give it for a shorter duration, the Debson converts hemoglobin to methemoglobin, which has a reduced oxygen carrying capacity. And because of this reduced oxygen carrying capacity, there is buildup of the carboxy hemoglobin, or there is buildup of the carbon dioxide. And this can lead to the effects like cyanosis, both peripheral and central. So when a patient who is on Debson starts to develop cyanosis, always go for arterial blood gas to look for the levels of methemoglobin. Okay, so that is again a repeat question, I guess it was from FMG. Which is not seen in Behçet's disease? Recurrent oral ulcers, erythema induratum, recurrent genital ulcers, or superficial thrombophlebitis? Which is not seen in Behçet's disease? Recurrent oral ulcers, erythema induratum, recurrent genital ulcers, or superficial thrombophlebitis? Harshita, Ruhi, Damari, Shreya, everyone, we have a good number of students. Let's see how many of you can answer this question. Behçet's disease, I hope you remember, it's a neutrophilic dermatosis. Neutrophilic dermatosis. And how does it present? It presents with orogenital aphthous ulcer, eye involvement, joint involvement, everything. Okay? Which is not seen? Please remember, recurrent oral ulcer seen. Genital ulcers seen. You tend to see superficial thrombophlebitis. You tend to see furunculosis. You tend to see erythema nodosum. Erythema induratum is not a feature. You will see erythema nodosum, and that is why the correct answer becomes option number 2. Erythema nodosum is seen, but erythema induratum is not seen in the patients of Behçet's disease. And lastly, a patient present with some reddish yellow staining, axillary hair, the likely organism causing this, can you tell me the answer? Corynebacteria tenias, Minutissimum, Candida albicans, or Trichophyton species? Anybody can tell me the answers? A patient present with the red yellow staining of the axillary hairs, the likely organism could be. Very nice, Rajeshwari, Raj Ravi, Damari, Aditi, Ruhi, Barsha. Very nice. Now, yellow, red and yellow staining of axillary hair, it's a feature of trichomycosis axillaris. एक्सिलरिस, ठीक है जी. एंड इन ट्राइकोमाइकोसिस एक्सिलरिस द कॉजेटिव एजेंट इज कोरिनेबैक्टीरिया टीनियस. इट इज नॉट कोरिनेबैक्टीरिया माइनोटिसिमम, इट इज कोरिनेबैक्टीरिया टीनियस. सो निकिता, शोभा, देन वी हैव विशालक्षी, श्रेया, प्लीज रिमेंबर द ऑप्शन नंबर टू. दिस इज अ कॉजेटिव एजेंट फॉर इरिथ्राजमा, बट द कॉजेटिव एजेंट ऑफ ट्राइकोमाइकोसिस एक्सिलरिस इज द कोरिनेबैक्टीरिया टीनियस. ठीक है जी, understood all of you, very important, try to remember, do not get confused. Minutissimum is erythrasma and tenias is trichomycosis axillaris. Coming to the next question, I think it would be best if I move the image little on the left, it becomes clear for you to visualize it. A man 30 year old present with pustular lesions, I think this was a AIIMS question, repeat. He has been taking treatment for acne with doxycycline. His other acne lesions like papules, comedones subsided with the treatment, but these papules soon develops and were unresponsive to the medication. Harshita, in dermatology the important topic would be STD with respect to INICT, because we have seen around 50% of the total question in the last INICT from STD alone. So if you have no time for reading dermatology, and if you have only 1 hour, 2 hour, please go with STD, okay? And other than this, I think leprosy is important, psoriasis, vesiculobullous disorders, basics, very important, cutaneous malignancies, very important. And I request you to please join my plus courses, because I'm going up with the INICT revision right now. So please join my plus course, use the code Dr. Cheshta YT. Please use this code Dr. Cheshta YT and subscribe to an academy. Okay, ji? Okay. Now, here the answer is gram-negative folliculitis. Why it is gram-negative folliculitis? Why it is not pustular acne? Because the acne lesions, they are responding to the drug, but only the pustular lesions are not responding. So, please remember, it means that they have developed a bacteria or a species organism which is non-responsive to this drug, and it is most frequently gram-negative organism which is not taken up by the doxycycline. So the correct answer becomes option number 2, that is gram-negative folliculitis. Okay? Okay, ji. Max Joseph Space is a histopathological image of anyone. Mishba, doxy will not treat these lesions. You have to change, or you have to give an alternative drug for that. A Max Joseph space is a histopathological feature of psoriasis vulgaris, pityriasis rosea, lichen planus or parapsoriasis. What could be your answer, anyone? Max Joseph space is a feature of, very nice Rajat, absolutely right, Shreya, Madhu, Mishba. So the Max Joseph space is a histopathological feature of, the correct answer would be lichen planus. What happens in the patient of lichen planus? You have damage to the stratum basale. Okay, you have damage to stratum basale. There is degeneration of the stratum basale, giving rise to formation of degenerated bodies or apoptotic bodies, which is called as colloid body, civet body. Now, these colloid body and civet body, they will absorb with time, leaving behind the empty spaces, and that is called as Max Joseph space. Okay, I hope that is clear to all of you. And with this, we are done with the today's session. I hope you have enjoyed. We have discussed a lot of questions. We have tried to cover one question every minute along with the important high yield point. If you like this class, please give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the YouTube channel, that is Let's Crack Neet PG. You can follow me on the Telegram group. You can press the bell icon to get all the notification. And please subscribe to Unacademy. Use the code to get additional 10% discount on the subscription. So bye bye all of you.